charges on the
weapon.
Sir, I'm hold this.
We want to open it.
You can open it.
Next, I'll request Kadai. They have a presentation.
Yes, sir.
We can see that.
Let it be launched with the Honorable Minister here. Sir.
Yola.
Yes.
Is the launch of the NERADCO portal and the app.
इन दोनों के बारे में जब हमारा कॉन्फ्रेंस आगे का जब वर्कशॉप होगी इसमें NERADCO और CREDAI के द्वारा डिटेल प्रेजेंटेशन किया जाएगा कि कैसे ये काम करेगा.
टू रिमूव
सर, यू रिमूव दिस.
नहीं नहीं आप नहीं 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 आप खड़े नहीं होइए, बाकी
यू
मूव. ब्लॉकिंग द स्क्रीन.
कैमरा लगा के
आप यहाँ सामने से स्क्रीन को रोक रहे हैं.
जल्दी लगाओ.
भाई आप चल निकलिए प्लीज.
जी
थैंक यू वेरी मच NERADCO एंड CREDAI. सर नेक्स्ट सर इन द फॉलो अप इज द कमेंट्स बाय द इंडस्ट्री लीडर्स. सर आई विल फर्स्ट इनवाइट जक्षेश शाह द चेयरमैन ऑफ CREDAI नेशनल एंड as has been requested we will stick to the 3-minute margin because everybody has to be taken up and the honorable minister has other pressing engagements, so I'll request Jaksha Shaji to just come up.
सर आपकी प्रतिभा और आप जो एविएशन में अभी पूरे वर्ल्ड में कई छोटे बच्चे से लेके बुजुर्ग तक. Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
सर इतने लोग प्रभावित है जिस इंडिया की सॉफ्ट साइड और थॉटफुलनेस और एक संवेदना के साथ ये आपने वंदे मातरम उड़ान जो आपने पूरे वर्ल्ड में. वी आर सो प्राउड ऑफ यू एंड वर्ल्ड ओवर सिटीजन जो इंडियन सिटीजन आर सो प्राउड ऑफ यू सर. थैंक यू सो मच सर. सुषमा जी के बाद अगर कोई एक टच आया है सर पूरे वर्ल्ड में सर आपके थ्रू आया, दे आर सो प्राउड ऑफ यू. और सेम थिंग आप और पीएस मिश्रा सर उनकी टीम हमारी हाउसिंग मिनिस्ट्री में जो काम कर रहे हैं लगातार, मुझे लग रहा है सर ये कोविंद से पहले से डबल स्पीड में काम कोविंद में हो रहा है सर, ऐसा मुझे एहसास हो रहा है CREDAI के सब मेंबर्स को. थैंक यू सर. माय प्रेसिडेंट सतीश जी, आर वाइस प्रेसिडेंट बमन जी, निरंजन सर, संजय सर और ऑल माय कलीग्स एंड टीम, जस्ट सो हैप्पी टू एंड प्राउड टू लॉन्च दिस CREDAI आवास ऐप. CREDAI भरोसा है सर, नाउ इज अ गेटवे टू द वर्ल्ड. मैं मिश्रा सर ये इज नॉट ओनली इंडिया, नाउ एनी कस्टमर थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड ऑन अ क्लिक ऑन अ माउस दे कैन रजिस्टर. देयर आर रजिस्टर CREDAI स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 10 लाख अफोर्डेबल हाउसिंग स्टार्टिंग 10 लाख रुपया से लेके एंड कंप्लीटेड टैक्स अभी कर सकते हैं एंड टू एंड पूरा डिजिटल. जो प्रधानमंत्री जी का जो हमारा स्वप्न है डिजिटल इंडिया का, उसको पूरी तरह आत्मनिर्भरता के साथ और बेझिझक कोई मिडलमैन नहीं डायरेक्ट डेवलपर से प्रॉपर्टी खरीद कर सकता है और मुझे बहुत गर्व है. और सर मैं आपको बताऊं CREDAI आवास है अभी 21 स्टेट चैप और 141 लगभग 140 से ज्यादा सिटी तक पहुंच गए हैं और हम आशा करते हैं हमारे प्रेसिडेंट सतीश मगर पूरी टीम हम ये दोनों सिटी तक 3 महीने में लेके जाएंगे बाय एंड ऑफ 2020। सो आपने हमें ये अवसर दिया, ये अपॉर्चुनिटी दी है, उसके लिए हम और दोनों साथ।
नेक्स्ट इज राजन मंडेलकर जी, प्रेसिडेंट नरेटको वेस्ट। आई वुड नाउ रिक्वेस्ट यू टू गिव योर व्यूज।
नमस्कार सर। मिश्रा जी,
आर यू ऑडिबल?
सर आई एम ऑडिबल।
हाँ वेरी मच सर, बताइए
सर। यू आर नॉट विजिबल।
यस सर।
वेल नॉर्मली आपको तो माइक्रोफोन की जरूरत ही नहीं होनी चाहिए
सर। सर आपके और मिश्रा सर की होते हमारी आवाज बहुत बुलंद हो गई सर। सर टुडे इज अ वेरी वेरी हिस्टोरिक डे। सर सबसे बड़ा प्लस पॉइंट ये हो गया है कि सर जो हमारे जो मजदूर थे, जो हम सब जो घर में रह रहे, उनके बारे में पहले, हालांकि बहुत पहले अपन ने ख्याल करना चाहिए था, लेकिन वो नहीं कर पाए। लेकिन मुझे आज बहुत खुशी है उनके बारे में आज मिलेगा और उनके लिए रहने के लिए एक अच्छा आवास, अच्छा मकान, भले वो रहने होगा लेकिन उनको रहने के लिए मिलेगा। तो जिसका आज अनावरण किया हुआ है सारे सारे कंट्री के लिए। और दूसरा जो सबसे बड़ा इम्पोर्टेंट दिन है आज, हिस्टोरिक डे में इसलिए मानूंगा कि फर्स्ट टाइम ट्रांजेक्टेबल पोर्टल इवन क्रेडाई ने, क्रेडाई आवास करके ओपन किया हुआ है कि जो आज हमारे ब्रदरिन है इसके अंदर, और नेरेडको ने भी हाउसिंग, नेरेडको हाउसिंग और ऑल करके पोर्टल तैयार किया हुआ है। जो सिंपल कहना इतना ही है कि सर ये आप मिश्रा सर ने बोला कि यहाँ पे बैठ के चेन्नई में घर खरीदी सकते हैं, लेकिन सर ये यूरोप में कहीं पर भी अगर कोई आदमी कनाडा में बैठा है, लंदन में बैठा है, यूएस में बैठा है, वो घर खरीद सकता है। और इस दोनों पोर्टल को, दोनों रिकॉग्नाइज्ड एसोसिएशन है जो नेरेडको है और क्रेडा है, ये दोनों ने लॉन्च किया हो, इसलिए इसके अंदर से ग्राहकों को ट्रस्ट मिलेगी सर। और ग्राहकों को जो आज फेथ नहीं है या कॉन्फिडेंस नहीं है, वो कॉन्फिडेंस रिटर्न। मैं थोड़ा हमारे नेरेडको के सारे मेंबर, मेरे प्रेसिडेंट निरंजन हिरानंदानी, चेयरमैन राजीव तलवार, वाइस चेयरमैन प्रवीण जैन, दिल रेता और सारे लोगों के तरफ से तहे दिल से पूरी सर आपका, दुर्गा शंकर मिश्रा जी, दुर्गा शंकर मिश्रा जी को हम कहते हैं कि हमारे रियल एस्टेट के माता पिता वो है, क्योंकि दुर्गा और शंकर दोनों नाम वो आ रहे हैं सर। और मैं दिल से ये बात कहता हूँ कि उन्होंने 4 नवंबर जब अपन ने लखनऊ में रेरा का कॉन्क्लेव किया हुआ था, वहां पर हमने कहा था कि भाई ये अपने को पोर्टल करना है, और आपने उस दिन उसको हाँ भरी थी। और सर हमने 14 जनवरी नेतृत्व में हमने ये डेवलपर ऑनबोर्डिंग के लिए पोर्टल किया हुआ, और मुझे बहुत खुशी होती है कि आज हमारे पोर्टल पे 250 से ज्यादा अक्रॉस इंडिया सारे प्रोजेक्ट लाइव है। और ये घर बैठे लोग मकान देख सकते हैं, मकान सिलेक्ट कर सकते हैं, मकान का व्यू देख सकते हैं, मकान नॉर्थ फेसिंग है, साउथ फेसिंग है, टोटल आपके कितने मकान है, उसमें कितने मकान बिके हुए, कौन सा मकान कौन से फ्लोर पे खाली है, ये भी देख सकते हैं। और सबसे बड़ी बात हमने रखी है, दुर्गा शंकर मिश्रा जी ने मुझे बहुत ही बोला था कि अगर कस्टमर ने देखा हुआ और अगर उसको लगता है उसने पैसे दिया और कैंसिल करेगा तो कैंसिल करने के बाद क्या होगा। तो मैं नेरेडको की तरफ से आपको आश्वासन देना चाहता हूं कि सर हम अगर उस आदमी को लगा कि उसने बुक किया और उसको मकान पसंद नहीं आया और उसको कैंसिल करना है, तो हम उसको 1 रुपया भी बगैर काटे उसके पूरे के पूरे पैसे वापस दे रहे हैं सर। तो ये हमने क्या है कि आज जो ग्राहकों में कॉन्फिडेंस नहीं है, हम चाहते हैं कि इसके वजह से कॉन्फिडेंस आ जाए, और आज जो खरीदारी रुकी हुई है या धीमी गति से चल रही है वो 100% इसके वजह से इसमें बढ़ावा आएगा। और इंडस्ट्री आज कोरोना के चपेट में आकर जो तकलीफ आई है, और मैं वंस अगेन आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक महुआ एंड स्पेशली दुर्गा शंकर सर एंड अंडर द एबल लीडरशिप ऑफ पूरी सर, दे हैव हेल्प्ड अस बियॉन्ड मेजर्स। ऑफ कोर्स स्टिल वी स्टिल फील दैट देयर आर स्टिल थिंग्स टू बी डन इन द फाइनेंशियल इश्यूज, उट ऑफ इट्स प्रॉब्लम and get the entire country rolling and get the country out of recession. Thank you very much. You are obliged, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Rajanji. Now may I request Sanjay Dutt, the chairman of the FICCI Real Estate Committee, to give his comments on the ARC scheme and this initiative taken by the government as well as the Red Court tonight. Thank you.
A very good afternoon, Honorable Minister Durga Shankar Mishra ji, Niranjan ji, Satish Magar ji. We are grateful that this government has consistently delivered one simple message of direction to all the developers in the country, and that is care about people who need homes. So the stable direction and the consistent message that the minister and the government has given last few years, it has become a reality, a successful venture for all the developers. This scheme to promote affordable housing scheme conveys a very serious message that our government is proactive. Our government is thinking and assessing to the plight of people in the industry. And it's caring about people who are needy. And what we have witnessed, you have very swiftly, very efficiently, in a collaborative manner with the various bodies, have figured out a very successful scheme which go down the history as the typical. ₹2 lakh crores, which is stuck in ready inventory, and that unlocking of capital will give these developers who are stuck with their inventory to divert their capital into affordable rental housing schemes, sir. And at the same time, I don't know whether you noticed yesterday, the second REIT listing happened with 13x oversubscription, which gives one a recognition to you for your policies and transparencies that foreign investors are more bullish about you and the country as a whole, and they have capital to give. So why not take their $2 to $3 billion and invest in the real estate and not just banks and NBFCs, and free up that capital to invest in affordable rental housing scheme. So I have every faith and confidence in your leadership. And I'm grateful that we are at this historic moment make a difference to a very important segment of overall society. Thank you very much.
Already 100% FDI and ready-made housing kar diya ke nahi
kiya? Thank you very much.
Ready hai, usko kuch gap hai, usme kara raha hu
sir. Now request Sri Niranjan Hiranandan Mali ji, President of the Chair, and we are quite cognizant of this fact that you hear many hats, but as President Associate, I would request you to give your comments.
I think I would like to congratulate Neil Raheja for this yesterday, the REIT 13 times of this oversubscription. This is a wonderful news for the whole real estate agency, and I only hope that many others will come like this. About your other issue, I'm following very rigorously. Okay, thank you.
Okay, Hiranandan ji.
Namaskar, sir. My heartiest congratulations to all of you for the wonderful things that you have been doing. ASSOCHAM is extremely grateful for the entire policy measures that you have brought about. It is something unprecedented as far as industry and housing is concerned, and I think the entire policies that we are talking about will really flower out for revolution. Honorable Minister has taken us to the next level in terms of housing.
Thank you very
something
much.
Which has not been done Rehenani for many, many years before. So we are immensely grateful to you. Industry is there to invest and see to it.
Good afternoon,
that
sir.
The policies which are to the private sector, we will certainly take up. ASSOCHAM full support.
I must compliment
today.
You and the whole team. You have always taken fascinating efforts. Can you hear me, sir? Can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
We can't see you.
Thank you very much.
May I now request
Rehenaji, co-chairman of the EII National Committee on Housing and Real Estate, to give his comments.
So, you've done path-breaking efforts.
Good afternoon, sir.
I must compliment you and Swami Gashankar, the NBFC funding for real estate, and your whole team. You have always taken path-breaking efforts.
And most importantly,
can you hear me, sir? Can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
We can't see you. Can you also start your video?
The video is on, sir.
Carry on.
So, you've done path-breaking efforts, whether it's the Vande Bharat scheme, the Swami fund, which was announced, the NBFC funding for real estate, which has been announced, most importantly, the REITs and InvITs. As you rightly said, sir, there was 25,000 crores of applications done for global, institutional and Indian investors who came into our REIT, which closed day before yesterday. This is all the efforts announced by your government. And now, most importantly, the app which has just been launched. Sir, as you're aware that most of our cities are 40% slums, and I think you all are doing a great effort. And, you know, if I would like to recall that CII first presented the paper on rental housing 5 years ago, and I'm glad to see that we're seeing light of the day of this rental housing scheme. It will be very important for people who have been dishoused, migrant workers, and to achieve the Prime Minister's dream of housing for all. I would like to highlight that in Germany, 60% of the people live in rental housing. And while we have a shortfall of housing, we have 10% vacancy in housing. This will help achieve that. One of the things I'd like to highlight in this, the most important thing to help this rental scheme grow, sir, is to make sure the eviction is like a surfacey act. So when the period gets over, the owner, whether it's institution, global insurance companies, can vacate the thing after the tenure is over. And that will make sure that this rental housing scheme will be successful, because funding will be available only when people know that after the period is over or rent is not coming, it can be evicted. So that would be our suggestion from CII. We've already sent a note on this. The other area we'd like to highlight, sir, is RBI has always treated real estate as a stepchild. whether it is on the risk weightage, where same companies with a AAA in real estate are treated like BBB because we are real estate, as opposed to being treated as AAA risk weightage. Margins are kept higher. REITs and foreign portfolio investment, although announced by the finance minister in a budget, we are still waiting for the notification by RBI. ECBs are not permitted. So, sir, if we could take up with RBI comprehensive view for funding of real estate, more so because there are severe restrictions, it will go a long way in making sure rental housing is available and affordable housing available to achieve the Prime Minister's dream of housing. I'd like to compliment your team and you yourself, sir, and thank you for the time.
Okay, thank you, Neil Rajaji. There are a couple of more people, but I think we will take them in technical session and also in the question answer session. May I now request the Honorable Minister to address all of us and give his remarks and blessings. Thanks.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Durgaji. Thank you very much to all my friends who are separated by distance but connected visually. Jaksay ji, Rajan ji, Sanjay ji, Niranjan ji, Neil Raheja ji, all of you. I have a very well-prepared speech which has been, or address which has been drafted by my very professional team here. But I will have that uploaded and tweeted. But I want to utilize this opportunity to speak to you straight from the heart. Say a few things which I think deserve to be said at this juncture. First and foremost, let me say that when I joined the ministry in September 3rd, to be precise, in the year 2017, what appeared to me to be a challenge at that point of time was the comprehensive implementation of the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Because we had at that stage set for ourselves, on the basis of a demand assessment done by the ministry, a target of approximately 1 crore urban dwellings. And we were really at the beginning of that process. But a few months into the process, we started refining some of the verticals. I clearly remember, apart from affordable housing and partnership, the HB vertical, we started looking at CLSS, we started expanding the scope, the coverage for the MIG, we took it from EWS to LIG. But the expression in the English language is that the proof of the pudding, as they say, lies in the eating. The demand assessment went up, it went up from 1 crore to 1 crore 12 lakhs, but the beauty is that we have almost completed the sanctioning. And if the figures are correct, we have almost 70% of the grounding done.
Sir, they are correct, sir.
There are no question. No, I said if they are correct, mean marginal up and down, marginal up and down. So he says 65, I said 70. I'm taking it even higher. And I think if Durga Shankar Mishra ji starts having his monthly meetings on the committee of yes, sanctioning and monitoring of projects, I think that 1 crore 12 lakh will also be saturated, and you will, in the next few months, we will take that 70% grounding to 85-90% grounding. Now, by any yardstick, that is a fantastic achievement. Any yardstick. But I put that aside. See, what is it that the Prime Minister said? He said that it is his dream that every Indian, no matter where he or she lives, will have a home which he or she can call their own, which is a roof on their head. But the fact of the matter is, when you do a demand assessment, you get a demand assessment of 1 crore, 12 lakh, you can satisfy that, which we will, well before 2022. But there are other Indians, many people, you know, when I was young, and people had a different view on owning homes. They used to say, it is fools who build houses and wise men live in them. I mean, that was the current, that was the thinking. Why? Because it's not necessary. Today that philosophy has changed. But everybody wants to own a home.
People are aspirational, but there are a lot of people who may not want to own a home. They just want a place to live in. And I think the one lesson which came out of COVID, from my point of view, one, I agree with what all of you are saying. The speed of decision making has increased. We are now being able to take very bold decisions without files moving up and down. In fact, between my three ministries, most of my decisions are taken on WhatsApp. Which means if Durga Shankar sends me a message at around 8:15 in the evening, by 8:45, I've read it and, you know, it's done. Now, I want to give you a taste of that. You know, I don't know when you came up with the idea of these two apps, Credai Avas app and the e-commerce portal of Naredco. My recollection is that Rajan Bandelkar ji caught me in the staircase between my room and my car on the ground floor, and he had just come with some of you after a meeting with the secretary Shri Durga Shankar Mishra, and they told me that, you know, we have this proposal, hum isko karne wale hai, ye hum banane wale hai, usme duniya bhar mein koi bhi kahin bhi hoga to wo us portal pe aake ghar ko dekh lega aur uspe, you know, you can do it. I remember that between the screen door and my car, I said, it's a damn good idea, go ahead. I don't think we are taking time on reacting to ideas. I was very deeply touched yesterday. One of you, I don't mind, if you don't mind my naming you, I had a phone call from one of you thanking us for what we had done on the REACH thing. I said, please tell him, I'll call back later. But you know, I was so busy with my other job. So I'm, you know, this is the kind of relationship we have. We supported that proposal and we backed it fully. But that's also the case in what we are doing now. If you want to do 100% FDI, in terms of affordable rental housing claims, I can tell you up front, I'm all for it. You want a statement, you want to quote me out of this, I'll say I'm all for it. Because I'm clear as to what our objectives are. Our objectives are that we have to cater to a situation where the urban population in the year of the Lord 2030 will be what? 600 million? I totally agree with somebody who said, usme se 40% jo log hain, they'll be living in informal settlements or slums. Now, in Delhi, we are trying to sort it out. In our three schemes, regularization of unauthorized colonies, jahan jhuggi, wahi makan, and land pooling, the face of Delhi will change. I can assure you on that, quite apart from the other mega projects we are doing. Look, I also believe, and I think many of you, I've had the privilege of personal interaction and guidance from you all. You know, when you are in a crisis, and you are looking at challenges that you face, my view, unlike many of my colleagues, I can share that with you. My view is that when you are in a crisis, you have to spend your way out of the crisis. And I can't think of any better way of getting out of the crisis than to step on the accelerator insofar as the construction industry is concerned. You know, you build, you incentivize, you revive economic activity. Well, there will be some blood on the floor because we have a regulator now, we have RERA, we have a market correcting mechanism, but we need your cooperation in that. And talking to you, I know we have your cooperation. Now, some of you, I mean, one of you in particular, whenever he comes to thank me, I always ask Shashi, who's in my office, are bhai, pooch lo, what is the next set of demands? So he always jokes, nahi nahi wo. To abhi abhi Rajan ji ne bola na ke bahut acha ho gaya, bahut dhanyawad, par kuch financial sector. Rajan ji, we are with you on that. But sometimes I think you and I should exchange jobs, or with Durga Shankar you can exchange a job. You see, put us, and we have the same challenges to face, because I'm sure my distinguished senior colleague, the finance minister, you know, she gets demands from all sectors. But look, somebody referred to the real estate as a stepchild. I'm not so sure. I'm going to ask one of my younger colleagues to do what we have done for the real estate sector. Look, I know that there is strain. Sector was under strain prior to COVID. COVID has exacerbated the strain. But wo stepmother wali or stepchild wali treatment nahi hai. I think if you collate all of it, you'll come to the conclusion that actually a fair amount has been done and it has been acknowledged by you. Equally, we draw strength from you. Because when we make proposals, we make proposals which are both realistic and if I may add, for the common good, for the larger public good. Now, why is this so important to have affordable real estate housing complexes? Because, not only because of the example of Germany, you see, a house must not be, owning a home must not be considered a be-all and end-all of one's existence. A home is something that you should feel comfortable with. No, it comes easier to me because for 40 years I was in another profession where every 3 years the government sent me to a different place. Other than those 6-7 years I had together in at headquarters as a joint secretary. But when you get used to the idea that today you're in a capital A and tomorrow you're in a capital B, you get used to the idea of mobility and changing home. Believe me, rental housing is necessary for our younger people. Those who have just started their professional life, they don't want to invest and be tied down. But more important, I think COVID has taught us a lesson that there are some segments of our society about whom we were not sufficiently mindful. And I'm talking about migrant labor. But the way, I mean, Rajiv Talwar, I can see him sitting there very seriously. He and I once had a chat and both of us agreed that once you are able to provide affordable rental housing in a manner which makes it easy for anyone, you as the owners of the economic entities, as the builders, you'll find it much better to easier to retain your working, the workers, etc. You will be able to move them from project to project because you might want to invest in rental housing as a company. And the individuals might want to do it. But once we have that done, we'll be in a situation where the kind of problems we had to face on account of migrant labor wanting to move, now they're coming back, etc., it will be taken care of. And our cities will look more organized. They will not be fending for themselves in informal settlements where there is no, the basic amenities of what urban life should be will not be. So I'm delighted that we have launched these two portals, and that I'm very happy. Congratulations. I was even more happy because this is an idea which, you know, came very recently and we've been able to implement it. But I'm equally happy that we're all working together. Now I'm going to spring a surprise on you. You see, I was having a meeting with the former chief minister of Maharashtra, Devendra Fadnavis ji, with some of you were present there in that meeting. The problem was relating to my civil aviation part, where, you know, there is some problem on the heights of buildings and lack of clarity on policy. So a request was made, or I made the suggestion, that we will set up a permanent working group. The permanent working group, which would have members from CREDAI, NAREDCO, so that people don't have to come to the minister and to this thing. We discuss things there. It is there with the industry. Our airports authority people will be there, civil aviation. I am willing to look at such a PWG for areas other than civil aviation also, where some of the things you are discussing, what are the issues which should go to the finance minister. You are doing it in any case sporadically. I know that between Rajan and Jakshaji and others, you come and meet secretary. Occasionally you come and meet me also. But, you know, you could have a meeting of the you can set up a PWG, have a meeting on one, let's say the first Monday or the first Friday of every month, where there's a proper agenda. It will make it much more organized and efficient. And then the minutes of that, you know, you can monitor the progress. So I'm willing to make that suggestion. Normally, suggestions come from your side. But I saw the PWG working in the civil aviation, where they had, I think, their first meeting 1 or 2 days ago. So I'm quite happy to put that on the table. But more than that, I think now, this is my final message. Whether it is work on our pending projects, whether it is work on smart cities, today I think we've reached the watershed mark in our COVID overall challenge. I think we should now step on the gas and revive economic activity, make sure people get back to work. And there is a favorite, of course, pending proposal of mine on the NULM side, which is the skilling of people. So please, I'm going to come back. I'm sorry, I remind you on that. That's my wish list with you, so that we bring in people, no matter from which state they are, give them 15% classroom time, 85% time on the project, so that they're able to grow, you know, and A, answer your shortages, respond to your shortages in the skill sector. But more than that, there is overall growth without these impediments. And Sanjay Kumar, who's not here, the joint secretary in charge of NULM, he keeps assuring me that's happening. And when I see Niranjan, my friend there, I draw strength because I know he's the one who suggested this proposal. So once again, congratulations. Thank you very much. And we'll take it up from here. As I said, I can't recall a single proposal which you guys make which is not acted on from our side. Yes, we try and modulate it, but because I think we have a reasonably good understanding of where we are headed and the tremendous opportunities we have, I hope in 6 months' time when we meet, we will refer to the slowing down of activity as something in the past 10, and we will be able to revive it. A lot of good things have happened, and we must exploit that potential. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Very kind words, sir. Now, this part of the program will
just finish. Right.
And after the Honorable Minister leaves, we will begin with the technical session where we will have more speakers from you. But for the moment, we'll just break for.
I have another meeting. I have another meeting. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.